Welcome to video 6 on Fun with Arduino. In the previous 5 videos we already became quite the experts in LED lighting controlled by Arduino. And guess what? There's this tech company that likes to bring a module to the market, but their own hardware and software development is fully booked, too busy. So they reached out to us if we would be interested in making the first prototype. Well, are we? Yes, of course we are. We can do that. So their next email, they sent us their specifications. And this is what we need to do. An automatic day and night cycle that runs indefinitely. And the times must be easy configurable. And there should be a switch panel with a toggle switch to switch the cycle on and off, and an LED that shows the status of the cycle. Well, okay, let's do the hardware first. We can connect a FET module to power some LEDs on pin 8. Then we can have a toggle switch on pin 2 as the on-off input pin. And we need to add an LED and a series resistor, of course, that is going to be on our switch panel. Well, this is the hardware. Let's go to the software. We can start with the software we already had in video 4 and make a couple of changes to do our first test. This name of the push button I'm going to change in the cycle on off switch. I don't mind long names, this is good readable. Street lights I'm going to make a bit more general, just lights. Then we have the LED on time. Yeah, the lights are on during the night, so I change that into night time. And then to add the daytime, just copy and paste that line. And now we also have a configurable daytime. That should do it in that section. Then in the setup section, we change the name of the push button into our new switch. And I change the lights, take out that street. Then we go to our loop. Yeah, where that push button, that is our switch now. If our switch is low, connected to ground, then our lights go high, switch on. Then we wait, we delay night time. Delay means the Arduino is doing nothing, just tapping its fingers. Then our lights go off again, and then we are going to delay the daytime. And that should do it. We are now ready to do our first test, because we now made a complete cycle. Lights on, wait for the nighttime, lights off, wait for the daytime, and then it starts to loop again. Let's try this out. Over here we have our brand new super duper switch panel with a toggle switch and an LED. In case maybe you do not have a switch at home, just connect your pin 2 wire to ground to simulate that switch. The FET module is connected and the LEDs are connected just like in video 5. I changed the night and day times to 3 seconds and 2 seconds, and let us just switch it on. Yeah, there we have the night cycle, fully automatic day cycle, night cycle again. And well, if I now switch it off, we will see that it does not start again. Mission accomplished. We need to add the LED over here. Okay, let's add our switch panel indicator LED. Well, that's quite a long name. Let's just call it LED. I'm going to define a new pin, the LED pin. And then if you remember from the hardware diagram, I connected that to pin A5. Yeah, that's an experiment. As you have noticed probably on the Arduino, there's a section of pins that are labeled analog in. And the question is, yeah, fine, can we also use them maybe as digital pins, in this case as a digital out? Well, let's just try that. So let's allocate pin A5 to be our LED pin. That means that I also have to make a pin here in the setup part. So let me copy this one and make this our LED pin. Then it is there. It's A5. Now the question is in our loop, when is that switch panel indicator LED going on and when is it going off? Well, it's going on as long as the cycle is running. So we need another digital write statement here. I copy and paste this one, and then make this the LED pin. So it's now high, it's burning as long as this cycle is running. But if the cycle switch is off again, which means this is not low but high, thanks to our pull-up resistor, then that means I now need this else statement again. Then we are going to digital write LED pin low. Okay, LED pin. And now I probably need another bracket here, or did I already get that? Yeah, that is correct. This bracket, if I click it, you see that one highlighted, so that belongs to each other. I click this one and then this one is highlighted. That highlighting is not very obvious, but it's there. And this one belongs to that one. That should do it. Let's try this out. We now have added our switch panel indication LED. Okay, the moment of truth. We have now wired this LED over here to pin A5 of the Arduino, which is labeled as analog in. But let's see if it can act as a digital out. I'm going to switch the lights on again. Yeah, we see the switch panel LED has lit up, so that's all perfectly okay. We have accomplished our mission. I'm switching it off. It's the LED stays on until the cycle has ended. Yeah, right now. So now let's have a look at the ease of configuration. Actually, if the module is hardwired, a user never needs to change the pin numbers, only the timers can be altered. So let's place those at the top of our code and maybe add a little command that this is the section for user configuration. And maybe also copy paste it over here. This is the end of the user configuration. So the only two things that the user needs to change over here, if he wants to, is the timers. And I don't like these very large numbers, they are error prone. Let's change those into seconds so that they are a bit better, easier readable. That's okay, but now of course our delay statements, they need milliseconds, but luckily our Arduino is a computer that can do mathematics, so we can simply multiply here by 1000. And then the delay statement is fed by seconds times 1000 is milliseconds, so that should again be okay. Let's try it out, but not with these very long timers, they make us wait too long. 3 seconds for the night and 2 seconds for the day, and we do our final test. Alright, final test to see if the multiplication works well. Switch on again. Yeah, the onboard LED is on, the lighting on the layout is on, everything seems to be okay. I'm going to switch it off right now, and only if the cycle ended, my switch panel LED goes off. This was it in this video. Now let's see if the company is happy with what we did. I'm not very happy with the ease of configuration yet, so maybe that could become a bit better in our next video.